So let's move ahead to the next scenario, adding new customer type scenario. Now this scenario is again a very frequently occurring problem, and when this problem occurs, it's a clear violation of the open close principle. So let's try to understand this scenario, and let's try to understand, you know, this concept called as open close principle. Now the application is a simple customer discount calculator, wherein you can go and put in the customer name, you can put in the amount, and then there is a drop down called as customer type. So depending on what type of customer you select, the taxes are calculated. So for example, if I select a free customer, then there is no tax for the free customer. So what it does is, when I actually click on the calculate tax button, it says the name of the customer. So for now, the name of the customer is Shiv. So it just says Shiv has paid 100 and has been given discount of 0. If I select the paid customer and I hit, then again there's a different message, you know, saying that Shiv has paid 100 and the given discount is of 10. Now let's go and see what is there at the backend code. Now the project is divided into two sections. The first section is the form, the user interface, which we just saw. And the second section is a customer class. Now the heart of this whole system is this customer class. So the customer class has three properties here: customer name, amount, and the customer type. Now this customer type is nothing but it's an enum. So you can see that it's a simple enum with, you know, free, paid, and, you know, the different types of customer what your system has. And then it also has a discount property, and this discount property is calculated depending on what kind of enum you have sent to this class. So for example, if the customer enum is free, right, if the customer type is free, then he will return the discount as 0, or else, you know, he will return the discount as 0.1. So in other words, this customer class is consumed in the form. So if you remember, right, the form which we just played before you, so when you hit the calculate tax button, what you do is basically you create the object of this customer class, you pass him the amount, you pass him the name, and then basically you also pass him the enum, and then depending on that, the discount is calculated. So that was the code, you know, actually, you know, for the customer screen which we just displayed. Now the question is, what is the problem? Now let's say we want to add one more customer type called as gold customer. So what things we need to do? First thing is, we need to go to the enum and we need to add one more type here called as gold. So I'll say this is change number 1. So here I will add a customer type called as gold, and this is a comma. Okay, so this is the first change, that we first went ahead and we added a enum called as gold. The second is, definitely we need to go and add one more if condition here. So saying else if the customer type is equal to cust type dot gold, then return amount into 0.2, right? So this is for the free customers, this is for the gold customers, and this one is the paid customer. So by default, if it's neither free neither gold, it will return the paid customer value, discount value. So in other words, in order to add a new customer, we made two changes. One is in the enum and the other is in the discount property. We went ahead and we put an extra if condition. The first problem with this approach is testing. To add a new customer type, I am going and modifying the current customer code. I'm modifying the current customer code which is working. I'm modifying the current customer code which is time tested. So in other words, because I have modified the current code, I also need to check now the old test scenarios. For example, I also need to check, you know, and I need to rerun the test cases to see that if the free is working properly, if the paid customers are working properly, you know, because of this logic which we have added here, you know, is it going and affecting the other logics? Now this thing is not only true, you know, when you're adding a new customer type, also when you're modifying a new customer type. For example, let's say for some reason you want to go and modify the gold customer type. So you have to again rerun the complete logic, you know, which are also for other tests, for other customer types. So in other words, your testing cycles have increased, you know, for each addition of new customer type as well as modification of new customer types. And the second problem is, the current customer class or the current approach of adding the new customer type is not following single responsibility principle. In other words, this class is doing the calculation for free customers. This class is doing the calculation of discount for the paid customers, for gold customers and whatnot. And tomorrow, as you add new customer types, you know, this class will also do the calculation for those customer types. In other words, you know, this class is getting overloaded with too many things. So the first problem is we have to do testing for all the test cases, you know, for all the old scenarios. And the second problem is this approach doesn't follow our single responsibility principle. So what kind of solution is appropriate here, or what kind of changes do we need to make in this project to ensure that we don't need to change the existing code, what is working? And second, you know, how do we actually implement the single responsibility principle?